Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are cooking OFE Nsala with goat's meat, also known as white soup. This soup is very easy to make and very delicious. So watch this video to the end to see how we made this soup. Okay. So let us start cooking. In our pot, we have our washed goat's meat, okay? Ofe Nsala is a delicacy from the Igbo people of the southern eastern part of Nigeria. You can make this soup with any protein of your choice. Today, I'm using goat's meat. You can make it with chicken, turkey, assorted beef, and even fish, okay? To make this soup, we'll be needing some dry catfish. This has been washed and deboned. Some stockfish, crayfish, yam flour. This is what will thicken our soup. The ideal is to go for the fresh yam, but this is a good alternative if you do not have the fresh yam. This is yam flour. Our star ingredient, Nsala spice. This takes our soup from basic to the next level. Without this spice, you can't cook the Ofe Nsala soup. Okay? This is a mixture of different herbs and spice. Some salt and 2 bullion cubes. Habanero pepper and 1 onion. You can skip onions if you do not like onions in your soup. And lastly, this is dry Uziza and Utazi. Okay, this has been soaking for an hour now. Okay, you can go for the fresh one. Okay, in our pot, we're going to add our Scotch bonnet peppers and onions. I already blended this. You can chop if that is better for you. I prefer it blended. So we're going to add that into our pot. Our stockfish, some of that pepper soup spice, some salt, our 2 bullion cubes. So we're going to mix that in. We're going to let this cook for 15 to 20 minutes or until it is soft, okay? For me, I like to steam a bit before I add water. Okay, this has been steaming for 5 minutes, so we're going to add water. Okay? The amount of water you put to cook it also determine the amount, the level of the soup, okay? So you do not want to put too much water or too little of water. Just enough to cook the meat and then for you to have your soup, okay? Okay? So our meat has been cooking for up to 20 minutes now. And as you can see, it's soft, okay? So at this point, we're going to add our dry fish. Our crayfish. More of our Nsala spice. We're going to add some water. Now the level of water you add is the level of water you want your soup to be. Okay, so do not add too much water or too less water. You add the amount of water you want for your soup. So I'm going to stir all of that in. So I'm going to let that boil for 5 to 10 minutes. So our soup has been cooking for 5 minutes now. So we went ahead to dissolve our yam flour with water. Okay. This will make it our soup to be thick. This will thicken our soup. So I'm going to add in some. So please do not stir, it will dissolve on its own. If you stir, it's going to cause lumps. So just leave it, it will dissolve into the soup on its own. As you can see, our soup has thickened up, okay? I do not like my soup to be too thick, like porridge, but just in between, a bit light, a bit thick. Okay? And also know that the thickness, it will, once it gets cold, it's going to still thicken more than this. So you do not want it to be too thick in the pot. Because when it cools down, it's going to be thicker than this. Okay? So this is okay. So we're going to taste to adjust seasoning, okay? We're going to add a pinch of salt. And give that a stir. Our Nsala soup is coming together. So at this point, we'll add our Uziza and Utazi leaf, okay? So you do not want to add so much, just a little. Then we mix all that in. Our Nsala soup is ready. Thank you for watching this video. Please kindly like this video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Till the next video.